Vermicomposting. Vermicomposting is a method of making compost with the help of red worms. We know that earthworms are called farmers' friends. Red worm is a type of earthworm. Let us understand the process of vermicomposting in detail. First, we need to dig a pit about 30 centimeters deep. If it is not possible to find a place to dig a pit, you can even use a wooden box. This box should be placed where the temperature is neither too hot nor too cold. It means the box should be placed in a shade where there is no direct sunlight or snow. Spread a net or a chicken mesh at the bottom of the box. We can also spread 1 or 2 centimeters of thick layer of sand at the bottom of the box. Now we need to spread some vegetable wastes, including peels of fruits. One can also add dried animal dung, green leaves, pieces of newspaper, husk, etc. Remember, plastic coated or shiny paper should not be used. Now, water should be sprinkled to make the layer moist. But care should be taken that we do not use excess water. Also, the layer of waste should not be pressed. In fact, it should be kept loose so that it has sufficient air and moisture. Now, our pit is ready for the red worms to work on. We need to cover these worms either with a gunny bag or a layer of grass or an old sheet of cloth. Before covering the worms, we need to keep some food for them. The food may include fruit and vegetable peels, coffee and tea remains, and weeds. Remember that wastes that contain salt, pickles, oil, vinegar, meat, or milk should not be used as food for the worms, because these substances help in the growth of disease-causing small organisms. The red worm do not have teeth. They have a structure called a gizzard. It is advisable to add eggshells or seashells. The shells help the red worms to grind their food. Another interesting fact about a red worm is that it can eat food equal to its own weight in just one day. If proper care is taken of the worms, their number can become double in a month's time. Remember that red worms do not survive in very hot or very cold surroundings. Also, they need moisture around them. It is necessary to gently mix and move the top layer once in a few days so that it remains loose. After 4 weeks, observe the content carefully. You will find that it looks like soil. This means that the vermicompost is ready. Now, to remove the compost, we have to put some food wastes in one corner of the box so that the worms move towards it. Remove the compost from the vacated part and dry it in the sun for a few days. The remaining compost, which contains most of the worms, can be used to prepare more compost or share it with someone else. Once the compost is properly dried, it is ready to use. Vermicompost is an excellent manure and is also cost-effective. It can be used in pots, gardens, agricultural fields, etc.